On behalf of the Advanced Neuroscience Foundation Trust, it gives us immense pleasure to welcome you this evening to the Professor B. Ramamurthi Oration. I'm Krishna, your MC for this evening. I request you to kindly put your electronic devices on silent mode for the duration of the event. I request one and all to kindly arise for the invocation.
Ya Kundendu Tushara Dhavala Ya Shubhra Vastra
May I now request Mrs. Anaga Mukund Sridhar to kindly welcome this gathering.
Good evening. On behalf of the Advanced Neuroscience Foundation Trust, it gives me great pleasure to welcome all of you to the third oration of Professor Dr. B. Ramamurthi. We are honored that we have with us today the doyen of modern neurosurgery in the world, and someone who has and is still influencing the world of neuroscience. Thank you, Professor Madjid Samii, and welcome to Chennai. A special thanks to you for readily accepting Dr. Sridhar's invitation despite your very busy schedule. We'd also like to welcome Dr. Prashant Rajagopalan, Director, MGM Healthcare. Thank you for being a part of this program today. Last but certainly not the least, welcome to all dignitaries, senior doctors, friends, and members of the press who have come here this evening to celebrate the memory of Professor Dr. B. Ramamurthi. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. May I now request Professor K. Sridhar to lead, Professor Madjid Samii, Dr. Prashant Rajagopalan, Director, MGM Healthcare, and Mrs. Jayashree Sridhar, Managing Trust.
Everybody, the Advanced Neuroscience Foundation Trust was formed with the objective of spreading awareness regarding neuro-related problems. Our motto is prevention through awareness. And over the years, the Trust has been creating various platforms to interact with the public to spread the message of safety and early management. Our activities include newsletters, information booklets and brochures, awareness programs, camps and lectures. Our main focus over the years has been accident prevention and the golden hour. The brain tumor support group is another flagship activity of our trust. The brain tumor support group has been created and is successfully reaching out to hundreds of patients and their families. We also stress the importance of early management in strokes. We spread message regarding understanding the growing brain in children and also in inculcating lifestyle practices that result in a healthy spine. The ANF Trust works closely with schools and early learners to spread the message of safety first. Our Chikubuku comic series has been distributed to thousands of children over the years. We also carry the safety first message to young adults and college goers to instill in them the evils of drunken driving. Please note that India, particularly Tamil Nadu, has the highest number of road accidents, resulting in fatalities and severe injuries. Many young lives are lost on our roads, and this is a completely preventable man-made disaster. Be a safety first person is a message that we are taking to the society. The ANF Trust also conducts courses on basic life support. Walkathons, poster competitions, talks in social organizations, and of course our very prestigious annual Professor B Ramamurthi Oration are all being organized by the ANF Trust. Our future path is to take our safety messages to larger sections of society across the southern states with the help of NGOs, educational and government institutions, and with the support of print and the television media. I thank you all.
Thank you, ma'am, for enlightening us. Ladies and gentlemen, we are now proud to present Guru Samarpanam, a film about the legend Professor B. Ramamurthi by Dr. K. Sridhar.
At a time when the country was simmering in freedom fever, a spark of genius named Ramamurthi was born on 30th January 1922 into an illustrious family. Heeding the advice of his father, the young Ramamurthi joined the Madras Medical College in 1938 and had a brilliant academic career. He was steered into the then uncharted territory of neurosurgery by his surgical master and mentor, Dr. Narasimhaiya. Selected by the Madras government to train in neurosurgery under Robotham, he reached Newcastle upon Tyne on 2nd January 1949. He learned the ropes from the British, American, European, and Canadian schools of neurosurgery. Armed with such vivid knowledge in neurosurgery, Professor Ramamurthi embarked on a new journey back home in India and joined the unit of Sangam Lal on Vijayadasami.
Imagine General Hospital of 1950, one of the best hospitals in the country, not having a suction apparatus. Somehow he put it together, and that machine used to make such a thundering noise that the whole hospital used to vibrate, and people used to say, there is Ramamurthi operating.
The visit of Lawrence Walsh and Dennis Williams from Queen Square, London in the early 1960s helped establish the Madras School of Stereotaxy. In 1967, a separate head injury ward was established, the first of its kind in India. And in 1970, his dream of setting up an institute similar to what he saw at Montreal was realized. He served as the director of the Institute of Neurology and was principal of the Madras Medical College till his retirement in 1978. Not resting on his laurels, he went on to create another center of excellence in Madras, the Dr. A. Lakshmipathy Neurosurgical Center at the Voluntary Health Services Hospital. An ardent teacher, many students have been trained under Chief, as he was called, both at the MIN and at VHS. Sensing the need to streamline neurological sciences as a specialty, Professor BRM, together with Drs. Jacob Chandy, S.T. Narasimhan and Baldev Singh, started the Neurological Society of India in 1951 at Madras. Anywhere you went in the world, India was known as Ramamurthi's country, and he spread the word of Indian neurosurgery throughout the world. The WFNS and the WFN were held in India in 1989 when Professor BRM became the honorary president of the WFNS. He worked hard to spread awareness amongst public about common neurological problems like epilepsy, head injury, and meningomyelocele.
மூளை இருந்தா என்ன இல்லா போனா என்னங்கிற ஆட்டிடியூட் இருந்தா தலையில அடிபடுறதுனோட விபத்து தெரியாது. மூளையனோட குணம் எப்படின்னா, இது அடிபட்டுச்சுன்னா மூளையில திரும்பி வளராது, பாக்கி எல்லாம் வளரும். இந்த இருதயத்துல கூட சுத்தி காக்க கையில் போட்டா அது வேலை செய்யும். மூளையில அடிபட்டுச்சுன்னா மூளை ரப்சர் ஆகி போச்சா மறுபடியும் அது வளர முடியாது.
Many awards and titles were conferred upon him, and he had the rare distinction of being elected as the fellow of all three science academies of India. The greatness of the man we all know as BRM or Chief was in his persona. The person who would always make it a point to talk to the junior neurosurgeons and encourage them. The person who saw a massive shift in technology during his lifetime and not only accepted it, but also encouraged his associates to develop their skills.
I think it has been the most revolutionary step in the success of modern neurosurgery. Because the brain, as you know, is a very delicate structure. Even a 1 millimeter or 2 millimeter mistake can damage some function or other in the brain. That accuracy was not possible with the naked eye. We, of course, used to use a looking glass, magnifying glass, to operate. But then, when the microscope came, the picture changed entirely. A neurosurgeon can see even very small blood vessels which supply vital structures, can identify them, and then avoid them, not damage them. In the olden day, when they did not have a microscope, many small vessels had to be sacrificed. But with microsurgery, we are able to save a large number of savable structures. Your surgery has become more accurate. That is why the morbidity, that is the suffering of the patient, has gone down enormously in the last 10 years compared to last 40 years.
He constantly encouraged the next generation to step up and carry the torch forwards.
Here, we have to take on. The younger generation is very enthusiastic. The new technology is very good. So they will take on.
The person who touched the lives of many with a kind word, a personal gesture, with fatherly advice, with mentorship, and so much more. Prof. B. Ramamurthi, BRM, or Chief, however you may call him, he is still with us, with all of us, in his students, in the legacy of his work, and in the countless lives that he has touched.
May I now invite Dr. K. Sridhar to introduce the Professor B. Ramamurthi Oration and our esteemed orator.
Good evening, everybody, and welcome to this great evening where we remember this great human being who's remembered by every single person who has come, who had come in touch with him, who has been his patient, his student, his colleague. There is nobody who cannot remember him and feel an admiration for him. I was lucky that I was his nephew, but at the same time, more importantly, that I was trained by him. And even more important was that when I finished training, in the first discussions that we had on how I should further myself, what he said was, you must go to Hanover, Germany, and you must learn with Professor Madjid Samii. So I went to Hanover to learn under Professor Madjid Samii, and I learned so much what could be done. I learned the philosophies of how to do things properly. how not to do things, and basically how to think. I think that's very important. And therefore, it's with great pride, honor, happiness that I'm here today to invite my teacher also, who's the doyen of neurosurgery in the world today, Prof. Madjid Samii, to deliver the third Prof. B. Ramamurthi Oration. Thank you, Prof. Madjid Samii, for accepting. It is the first time he is in Chennai, Madras, as he said, and he couldn't really understand why Madras became Chennai. But thank you so much, sir, for coming here. I really pestered him, and he gave in at last. And it gives me a great pleasure to read the citation that we are going to be presenting to him. Professor Madjid Samii is a distinguished and world-renowned neurosurgeon and medical scientist. He is the founder president of the International Neurosciences Institute at Hanover, Germany, and professor emeritus of the Krankenhaus Neustadt and the Hanover School of Medicine. He is also the honorary president of the World Federation of Neurological Surgeons. Professor Samii was born in June 1937 in Tehran, Iran. He had his medical and neurosurgical education at the University of Mainz, and in 1970 he started his career at the same university. From 1996 till 2003, he was the chairman at both the Neustadt Hospital and the Hanover School of Medicine. In 2000, Professor Samii founded the INI at Hanover, and in 2004 became the president of the INI Beijing, China. And in 2010, the Tehran INI was planned. Professor Madjid Samii was the founding president of several national and international societies. He has received many honorary professorships, honorary doctorates, and several prestigious national and international awards, honors, and medals. He was the president of the World Federation of Neurosurgical Societies between 1997 and 2001, after which he continues as an honorary president. Professor Samii is editor, member of editorial board, and honorary editor of many medical journals, and has many original scientific publications to his name. A major aspect of Professor Samii's scientific career was his devotion to education and an enhancement of neurosurgery across the world. In 2002, his pupils and friends founded an international society, the Madjid Samii Society of International Neurosurgeons, also called the MASIN. And in 2011, the World Federation of Neurosurgical Societies, WFNS, in an unprecedented action, named its Medal of Honor after Professor Madjid Samii. The Advanced Neuroscience Foundation Trust Chennai, in partnership with the MGM Healthcare Chennai, is honored to present the citation to the Professor B. Ramamurthi Orator for 2019, Professor Madjid Samii.